It's gone. The skeleton is gone? It was definitely there a moment ago. Cue the music. I read movement. This room. Gillian, watch it! Shoot! Aim for the head! Well, we couldn't miss that.
Did I get it?
The Snatcher's functions have been terminated. There's no doubt now that this is their maintenance facility.
I knew it!
This one was probably still waiting to get its artificial skin installed.
So this is what they really look like, huh?
Yeah, that's the scariest thing about them. You can't tell them from real people once they've got that skin on.
Perhaps that's humanity's great weakness. We're always judging books by their cover.
And it's just that human weakness that they're out to take advantage of.
All right, Random. Metal, let's go. The HQ's junk squad can take care of him later. We've got an investigation to do.
For real this time? I think it's definitely dead or terminated this time. There's another reference. The Terminator. Yes, all of its functions have ceased. I don't read any residual energy either. Well, we should have been checking for residual energy and functions to begin with. Are you alright, Gillian? I'll live. You hit me twice, though. That was quite a tough customer. You get a few hundred of those together and that would be it. Gillian, let's get on with the investigation. Yeah, that was ridiculous. Bunch of amateurs, man. Random wasn't any help at all. The remains of the Snatcher are on the floor. Its functions have been completely terminated. It won't be moving again. Hold on, I got an itch. Wow. That was especially itchy. So I'm guessing there's nothing else to... There's nothing of note besides the medical equipment. So it looks like this is where they're doing their treatment. And the proof is over there on the floor. Don't let your guard down. His friends are probably around here somewhere. Yeah, yeah, quiet, Gillian. The stench from that Snatcher we wasted is still around. Well, we got past that, so... Let's go out in the hall. Just like that last one, you never know when they might pop out. Keep your blaster ready, Gillian. If there was one in the operating room, there are bound to be others. You never know, they could be hiding anywhere around here. I don't know. For a supposed hideout, there aren't very many of them. You be quiet. You rusted can... tin can... bolts and... levers and... So nothing new here. So I'm gonna move into... Let's try to hit door number 3 and see what happens. That door is closed. Let's investigate a different room first. Alright. Oh, that's right. We have to, use the switches. Just want to see what he says if we try to go in the door without the switch. This just says, use switch. 2! Door number 2 opened. Let's take a look in the second room. We're in room number 2. Look at this. Some kind of testing equipment is running. That's a real nasty sound. It's on my nerves, Random says. The room seems to be their real biotech research lab. Looks like Frankenstein could show up at any minute. It is well equipped with micro-manipulators, various types of lasers. It has a micro-surgery system. No cobwebs in this room, random notes. There are a number of jars for formaldehyde and other chemicals. The vast number of jars almost suggests a museum. Are those eyeballs bouncing around? Look at that. I just noticed that. There are a number of machines for biotech experiments. It seems they're quite serious about their work. They're all finest quality monitors, microscopes, and the like. Samples, mutated cells, and organs with tumors. I don't want to look at this stuff. We got a squeamish robot. The room is illuminated with red light. It makes for a very disquieting atmosphere. What are they doing here? What's with all these samples? This place looks like a lot more than a place to treat skin cancer. They're probably making more of themselves. Argon lasers, argon dye lasers. It's a device for selectively destroying certain types of cancer cells. They also have the latest gene cannon. Is that a real thing? Gene cannon? Sounds like someone's cell phone is vibrating. Everything is quite neatly organized. There are samples here of monoclonal antibodies. What in the world is that? Antibodies which are said to have beneficial effects on cancerous melanomas. There's no mistake, this is definitely their maintenance hospital. I think it's quite neatly organized. Alright, desktop. DNA synthesizers, DNA sequencers, a nucleic acid extractor, chromatography equipment, automatic pipetting devices. I don't know what that means. That's a particle accelerator used to generate a stream of heavy particles for a number of different treatment techniques. The machine is in standby mode. It looks like the Snatchers are working on artificial skin regeneration techniques, as well as various cancer treatments. And they grow back their skin quicker when they get damaged. This is quite an impressive array of equipment. Some university hospitals are not stacked this well. NMR, nuclear magnetic resonance, microscopes, STMs, scanning tunnel microscopes, high voltage electron microscopes, electron beam holography cameras, streak cameras. Gillian, the Snatchers obviously possess much greater intelligence than we have previously given them credit for. Nevertheless, their technology seems somewhat dated. Dated? What do you mean by that? I thought this was cutting-edge stuff. The equipment and techniques they are using, most of these methods were abandoned years ago. This is well behind the current level of technology in most developed countries. I thought you said this stuff we couldn't even find it in university hospitals. That's a rough approximation, but I would say that they are 20 to 30 years behind the times. What's more, judging from the imbalance of the research material here, it appears to be primarily the work of one individual. You're telling me that all this work on the Snatcher's artificial skin is being carried out by one person, and not some government institution? The design of this lab itself is in violation of a number of the biohazard prevention safety codes. While a few safety cabinets have been installed, there is no autoclave or gas sterilizer anywhere. This is quite far from P4 level. I seriously doubt that this lab was set up by a government or any other large organization. Well, that's a lot. That we got that from looking at the monitors? Yeah. I guess it's not so much that the equipment is advanced, but there's just a lot of it. There are a number of cell cultures and other specimens. It's all rather grotesque. The dates on these samples indicates that they are rather new. Woo! What a smell! Ugh. Smells a lot like rotting fish or something. That's the smell of decomposing protein, Random says. So that's the smell of cancerous skin cells, like Gibson wrote about? Huh? Ugh, I can't stand the smell. We can't look around the room. That skeleton back there is probably waiting to get his skin here, huh? You think this place is only used for skin treatment? You never know where they could be hiding. Let's keep conversation to an absolute minimum. Look at everything again, because we haven't found anything. There's a microsurgery system. Well, I was wondering if we were going to come across a snatcher in this room. They have the latest gene cannon, though. I mean, that's not outdated. If there's anything else to be found in here. Let's get out of here. Ugh, Random says, I feel sick. So now we're down to just room number 3. But how do we get in there? The third door is just like the other two. Only we can't open it. They're the same doors as we saw on the first floor. It says morgue. Morgue? As in where dead bodies are kept? Yep, that's the only meaning of the word morgue. There are no doorknobs or handles. It cannot be opened manually. There's only two buttons. Maybe it can be opened using those two buttons? Press both? Maybe at once? Maybe Random and I can both press a button at the same time? One and two at the same time.
Pushing both buttons simultaneously.
The two buttons are on opposite panels, so there's no way one person can push them both alone. But if two of us work together, it might do it.
That's it, Gillian. It makes perfect sense. It's the same system they used to use in nuclear missile silos in the late 20th century. Eliminates the risk of one man going nuts and acting alone.
Hmm. Well, it's hard to be sure, but let's give it a try anyway. I've got button one. Random, you push number two. You ready? On three. One, two, three! Come on!
That did it.
You did it! Door number three opened.
With safety measures like that, they must have had a good reason for wanting to keep it closed.
Yep. Thank you. Oh boy. Alright. Guess we're up to episode 24 now? Are you ready, Random? Let's have a look at the last room. Oh, good God.
Good God!
What? Oh my God.
It's their morgue!
Perhaps victims of the Snatchers?
Well, it doesn't look like whoever put them here was too worried about making sure they would rest in peace.
No, it doesn't. These have got to be their victims.
This is probably where they hide the bodies of the originals they snatch from places like Outer Heaven.
Who are we gonna find
they
here?
Probably picked Outer Heaven because it gets a lot of VIP traffic. Plus,
true.
During masquerade time, they could work the place and still keep their identities secret.
True.
Yeah, and the guy who set up the link between them and Outer Heaven was Freddy, that taxi driver.
Mm.
He must have gone after him, not because of who he was, but what he did. After all, with a taxi, there's plenty of chances to milk your customers for information. That's probably how they learned about Outer Heaven and Plato's Cavern.
I've been wondering what they had done with the bodies.
Huh.
Wanna hide a book? What better place than the library? Need to hide a body? How about the morgue?
And for them, keeping the bodies hidden is crucial. I mean, if somebody who's supposed to be dead is out walking the streets, it wouldn't be too hard to figure out that something screwy is going on.
That means that if we can figure out who these bodies were, then we've just nailed four Snatchers.
I swear, guys, I'm playing this completely blind. I have never seen this before. I've never played this before. So no, I had no idea he was going to say good God there, but that was funny as hell. I wonder how much smell in here. Ugh, what a horrible smell. It's an interesting song for a morgue. It appears to have been a proper morgue at one time, but now is being used as little more than a closet. Well, that was interesting. The music's changing up. It appears that they're just using this room to hide these bodies. There's a ventilation duct on one side of the room. I don't see anything except for the ventilation duct. Ugh. One of the bodies is still decomposing. The other three are little more than skeletons. I wonder if we could find out. Could one of them be the chief? Or, Harry Benson, engineer? Or are we gonna find the original cab driver and or his wife here? There's a cover on the duct, but it has been weakened by oxidation. Guess what? I guess we're going in there, aren't we? It has rusted somewhat, but it appears that it could be easily removed. Alright, let's investigate. There are a few droppings on the floor from mice who are no doubt feeding on the bodies. Lovely. The only thing in this room besides the bodies is some dust and scraps, as well as the maggots infesting the newest body. A number of different insect larvae have infested the body. It hasn't been well preserved, to say the least. But it's definitely a human body. I wonder if we can scan for DNA or something like that. Find out who they might have been. We have to look at them every time. It's really freaking nasty. Estimated time of death. The insects infesting a decomposing body can be divided into 8 large groups. Each of those groups works on the body for roughly 15 days, making it 8 by 15 day or 4-month cycle. As such, an analysis of the variety, number, and size of the organisms on the body allows a rather accurate estimation of which group is currently present. In other words, you can figure out how long the victim's been dead without analyzing the body itself, right? On this particular body, flies have laid eggs and the maggots have grown into adult flies, so it has been less than 30 days since death. As for the other three bodies, one full cycle has been completed, so at least 4 months have passed. That's really disgusting. Like, I really want to read that again. Well, I just did. Cause of death. Can you determine the cause of death? The bodies are severely damaged. Such a determination would require more extensive facilities than are available here. Identity, that's what I'm wondering. Identity. What about the identity of the victims? Hair, clothing, even teeth. Anything that could be used to make an identification is gone. No DNA from skin? They removed the teeth? Damn snatchers. There's teeth there! Those are teeth. They were careful to make sure their identities didn't get out. If we even had some teeth, we might be able to make an ID. As we're looking... the animation is disgusting here. As we're looking at a skeleton, a body that has teeth. There's even canines there. You can see there on the right. There's a canine there. There's a tooth longer than the others. Those are teeth. Oh, Random says, what about these teeth here? They've been deliberately misaligned to prevent identification. Oh. I guess we'll never be able to ID them. How could they tell they've been misaligned? There is a way. What? How? We can perform a simulated reconstruction. Fortunately, the skulls of the victims are still intact. Reconstruction, huh? Good idea. So I guess we can only identify this one? Great idea. Alright. Reconstruct corpse. Metal, let's do this reconstruction thing on the bodies. Are we gonna do it on all four?
Now performing simulated reconstruction of the head and facial features of each of the four victims. Commencing with victim number one. Now performing craniometric analysis. X-ray and sagittal X-ray, magnetic resonance imaging, and positron CT data gathered.
Wow.
Complete cranial data now being compiled. Craniometric analysis complete. Now commencing reconstruction.
I'm impressed.
First, victim's age. Estimate based on 1. Presence or absence of cranial fontanelles and chroma of epicranial sutures.
Oh.
2. Area of facial region and cranium. 3. Height of upper and lower jaw and development of alveolar part. And 4. Location of cranial center of gravity. Next, victim's sex. Estimate based on 1. Overall size of cranium. 2. Parietal bone angle. And 3. Development of splenocranium. Lastly, victim's race. Estimate based on 1. Overall cranial configuration. 2.
Oh.
Intracranial cavity. And 3. Mass of the skull.
Race and skull.
Now commencing soft feature reconstruction based on average results of above analysis.
There's different skulls?
Reconstructing. Initial phase completed. Margin of error on estimate of victim's race 10% based on use of average values. Now adding postulated hair and eye features. Reconstruction of head of first victim completed.
Who's that?
It's Freddie Nielsen.
Oh.
Moving on to second victim. Now commencing reconstruction of features of victim number 2.
I should have recognized
him. Now starting craniometric analysis. Complete cranial data now being compiled using the same techniques as the previous reconstruction.
The wife?
Craniometric analysis complete. Now commencing reconstruction using the same techniques as the previous reconstruction.
Makes sense. Yeah, reconstructing. You know.
Initial phase completed. Margin of error on estimate of victim's race 10% based on use of average values. Now adding postulated hair and eye features.
The wife.
Reconstruction of head of second victim completed.
Mrs. Nielsen.
Lisa Nielsen.
Moving on to third victim. Now commencing reconstruction of features of victim number 3. Now starting craniometric analysis. Complete cranial data now being compiled using the same techniques
as
the previous reconstruction. Craniometric analysis complete.
Now
commencing
Harry.
Reconstruction using the same techniques as the previous reconstruction.
Or the chief.
Reconstructing. Initial phase completed.
Looks like Napoleon.
Margin of error on estimate of victim's race 10% based on use of average values. Now adding postulated hair and eye features.
It is.
Construction of head of third victim.
Oh, that's the doctor.
Who in the world is that?
That's the director of Queen's Hospital. Shin Fui, what's his face?
So young.
Shin Shu Oh.
She Oh.
Moving on to last victim. Now commencing reconstruction of features of victim number 4.
Harry?
This one's the most recent. It's still decomposing.
Harry?
Now starting craniometric analysis.
Or the chief.
Complete cranial data now being compiled using the same techniques as the previous reconstruction. Craniometric analysis complete. Now commencing reconstruction using the same techniques as the previous reconstruction. Reconstructing. Initial phase completed. Margin of error on estimate of victim's race 10% based on use of averaged values. Now adding postulated hair and eye features. Reconstruction of head of final victim completed.
Is that the chief? Who is that?
It's the chief!
It is a chief.
What? The chief is a snatcher! The Benson on the scrap of that patient record was Benson Cunningham.
He looked different.
Judging from the condition of the body, I would estimate that the snatching took place approximately 1 month ago.
So it was the chief who sabotaged our turbo cycle.
What?
And those matches we found in Harry's room, the chief must have put them there to try to set him up.
The whole time?
No doubt Harry figured it out and decided to leave that face-to-face message. Wait
wow.
a minute. Didn't Mika say that Harry had left to go find the chief?
Yep.
That's right.
He knew something was up.
Probably trying to track down some evidence on the chief.
Gillian, I'd say that this Harry has put himself in a pretty dangerous spot.
Yep.
If it was the chief that sabotaged the turbo cycle, doesn't that mean that he already knows we're onto him?
Yes.
Harry and Mika are in danger.
That's far enough, Junker.
Uh-oh.
Your little investigation is over.
Who's that?
It's them!
Who? Snatchers? Get them!
No, don't get us. Ouch.
My arm! I can't reach my blaster! I'm hitting the leg!
Through the vent.
Is that the best you can do, Junker?
Who's there? Chin! Jin Shuo, you scum!
It seems you still have some fight left in you. You two are finished. But our plans move forward. We are now entering phase 2. And when we do, not only this city, but the entire world will be ours to command.
Phase 2? What are you talking about?
As you know, our operations have been hindered up to now by the flaws in our artificial skin.
Yep.
The skin's shortcomings have kept us away from ultraviolet rays, forcing us to do our work at night, underground, or in the winter. In the end, we had to construct a hospital like this, all because of the flaws in our artificial skin. This was the only difference between us and you humans. But now we have broken this barrier.
Huh?
We are on the verge of developing a perfect artificial skin, thanks to the cooperation of a new partner in our plan.
A new partner?
Perfect artificial skin? A new partner?
Harry?
Once we have the new skin, nothing will be able to stop us. And with that, our plan moves to phase 2. Our little experiment in this city will end, and we'll move in force to take over the world.
Don't be so sure. You won't get out of the city that easy.
You humans are always so overconfident, so naive.
So are you.
What are you talking about?
Just told us all your plans.
I'm sure you're aware that the Kyoto summit being held to decide how to handle the Snatcher problem opens tomorrow.
Metal, is that right?
That was a month from now.
Yes. Countries around the world are concerned about the Snatcher problem. It will be one of the main topics discussed at this year's summit.
That's right. Tomorrow, we attack the summit.
You must be crazy. The security there will be incredible. You won't even get close.
Must I explain everything to you, Junker?
Go ahead.
Aren't you even aware that a fellow Junker will be giving a special presentation at the summit?
The Chief?
The Chief! Cunningham! So that's why you snatched him.
We've known that your Chief would be speaking at the summit for over 3 months now.
Gillian, the summit is tomorrow. We have to hurry.
Listen, we have your Chief. You Junkers are at our mercy, and so is this city. And tomorrow, we move on the world! Nothing can stop us now. We will finally achieve our long-awaited goal of global domination!
I'll stop you, monster.
Who is this we you keep talking about?
We? We are an evolved life form. Given life in the depths of the Kremlin by our creator, Modnar. We are a new race!
Who?
Modnar?
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 Random.
Kremlin.
Backwards?
Names are familiar, but...
Our goal is to snatch all of the world's leaders, and then achieve total control of human thought and worldwide racial unification.
That's random backwards.
You're insane. Humanity won't be so easily dominated.
Isn't
you
it?
Underestimate the strength of the human spirit.
It is.
I think not. In the same way as the Nazis, our strategy begins
great.
With the overpowering of the spirit of the people. We will strike at you humans' weakest point, the most primitive part of your psychological makeup, your suspiciousness and fear. By provoking suspicion and mistrust throughout the populace, we will destroy that fragile fabric which holds your society together, that of trust. Fear is you humans' weak point. It is the primitive part of your brains that binds you forever to your animal ancestors and makes you vulnerable. By stimulating that part of your atavistic instincts, our plan can succeed magnificently.
Gillian, at this rate, they'll kill us all. You've got to get out alive. You're a Junker.
Just what have you have in mind?
I've got a big fireworks show ready for him. Better that than get snatched.
What? You're gonna blow yourself up?
No, we're better off fighting together. Hey, it won't work! I'm hit in the thigh! Ow! Oh, damn! A bounty hunter can't do anything with a leg wound like this. I might as well have been shot in the head.
There must be some way out of here.
Hey, oh, I wasn't doing this job just for fun. I stayed ready for situations like this. I've always been prepared to go out with a bang.
It's December. A little late for fireworks.
So it'll be an off-season show.
No, I can't let you.
My belt's packed with TNTPX. You know, that really strong stuff they use in the mines on Mars. One push, and this whole hospital will go. No trouble at all. No time to sit around thinking, Junker boy. Go! What are you doing? Get your butt moving, you fool! Get out through this air shaft. I've got a powerful strobe on me. Its flash will screw up their sensors long enough for you to get out. Now, you with me? Fireworks are better from a distance anyway, Gillian.
Are you two finished chatting? Then I think it's time for you to die. We're quite busy, you know.
You ready? When I give the signal, break into the air shaft and run. And don't forget your blaster.
Metal, stay with me.
Yes, sir.
Random.
Gillian. Doesn't look like I'm going to have a chance to call in that debt you owe me.
Don't worry. I'll pay it back to the Snatchers with interest.
All right, go.
This
run, Gillian.
Is this really going to happen?